ओके क्लास, वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू। आई एम दुर्गेश कुमार पांडे। आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अ टॉपिक इन पॉलिटिकल साइंस, इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस। यू नो फर्स्ट इट्स यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। फर्स्ट यू गो इन द हिस्ट्री। After the end of First World War, the prominent leader of the world, like the President of USA, Woodrow Wilson, and some other politician as an inter, which can. Politicians which are related to Britain, France, in European countries, were make a organization League of Nations. You know, League of Nations was made to reduce the conflicts between different countries, to avoid the war between different countries. And this League of Nations was working the welfare of common people, for the rights of human beings, like ILO, International Labour Organization. It was the agency and set up during the era of League of Nations, and he advocated for rights of citizens. Okay. All over the world. Okay, so after the establishment of League of Nations, the America USA was not become the member of this League of Nations because their own country and their own Senate was not permitted for this, and some countries of the Europe like France, Britain, Italy, you know, Hitler from the Germany and Mussolini from Italy, they were working and avoiding the UNO. They were many times broke the norms of UNO, norms of League of Nations. Okay, so that is why after the First World War, the situation was after some time change. Hitler became more powerful in the Europe, and other countries like Mussolini from Italy. So they were violated the norms of League of Nations, and with the time, the influence of League of Nations was near about ended, and now Second World War was starting. And in Second War, you know, the two city of Japan, Hiroshima and Nagasaki, was attacked by nuclear weapons by the America, and lakhs crore peoples were died during the Second World War. So the world famous leader like the Roosevelt of America, Churchill from Britain, and Stalin from USSR, they were worried about the future of the world. They were worried about the existence of human rights or humanity. So they come together and they were trying to make an international organization, and finally they were successful, and 24 October 1945 was the day. On this day, 24 October 1945, a new international organization was come into existence as UNO. United Nations Organization. This is an international organization, And the objective of this UNO to avoid the war, okay, reduce the tension between the countries, it work as a mediator between the countries, okay, and their main work is to reduce the conflicts, avoid the war between the different countries by mediating them, okay. And this UNO was established on 24 October 1945. On 30 October 1945, India was also joined UNO. Students, you know, initially on February 1945, in the Yalta conference, the three big powerful leaders, Roosevelt from America, Churchill from Great Britain, and Stalin from USSR, were come together to form the UNO as an international organization. It work in all over the country, and their aim is reduce the war, avoid the tension between the different countries by talking, by mediating. Student, I want to inform you that this UNO was the successor of old League of Nations, okay? And this UNO was take place the old international organization League of Nations. And you know, who was the first General Secretary of UNO? Tredway Lee. He was the first General Secretary from the Norway, and he became the first General Secretary of UNO. Class, you know who was the current General Secretary of UNO? The current General Secretary of UNO is Antonio Guterres. He is current General Secretary of UNO. Students, I want to give some another information about the organ of the UNO. You know, there are six organs of the UNO. First is General Assembly. Second one is Security Council. Third is Economical and Social Council. And the fourth is International Court of Justice. And next is Secretariat, and sixth is Trusteeship Council. Okay class, here I explain each organ individually. First start from the Security Council. You know, Security Council have a 5 permanent member and they have a veto power. Which are the 5 permanent members in the Security Council? They are China, Russia, USA, Britain, and France. These are the 5 permanent members in the Security Council. And to make Security Council more representative, their strength was increased, and now strength is increased, and now 10 another members were joined there, and total strength is 8 of this organ is 15. 5 permanent and 10 non-permanent members are elected here. 5 permanent members, you know, they have a veto right. What is veto right? Veto right is a power if any one country among the 5 are not agree on the decision of Security Council, the Security Council cannot take any action. Agar ek ne bhi mana kar diya, to wo kaam nahi hoga. Security Council wo kaam nahi karegi. This is a veto power. Okay? So if these 5 permanent members have a veto power, okay? Or iske alawa 10 non-permanent member hote hain, and they are elected for 2 years and alternatively, And there was a effort कि इस सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल को और ज़्यादा रिप्रेजेंटेटिव बनाया जाए एंड सम मेंबर्स आर कमिंग फ्रॉम लैटिन अमेरिकन कंट्रीज फ्रॉम अफ्रीका साउथ एशिया साउथ ईस्ट एशिया ईस्टर्न यूरोप में से ये ट्राई किया गया कि किसी न किसी को कोई ना कोई पार्ट दिया जाए मतलब हर सारे पार्ट से कोई ना कोई रिप्रेजेंटेटिव सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल में आए तो टोटल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल इज 15 फाइव परमानेंट एंड 10 नॉन परमानेंट मेंबर्स हु आर इलेक्टेड फॉर 2 ईयर अल्टरनेटिवली ओके क्लास क्लास नाउ कम ऑन द सेकेंड पॉइंट सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल सॉरी क्लास I take another point, General Assembly. You know, class, this General Assembly is working like a parliament in our country. And in the same time, in the international organization, it work as a parliament. And their current strength is 193. 193 members are in the General Assembly in the present time. You know, South Sudan was another country who joined the South Sudan was the last country who joined the General Assembly. Now total strength of General Assembly is 193. Okay, class, 193 members are at the present. They are the member of General Assembly and in General Assembly is working like a parliament from the, all over the world many representatives are come here and every country have a right to send their at least one member in the General Assembly so this body is very representative body of UNO okay People raise their voices and raise the issue and raise their problem in this assembly. Okay? Class, next organ is Economical and Social Council. You know, this Economical and Social Council, UNO was doing the economical and social welfare of society. For economic and social welfare of world by the Economical and Social Council. You know class how the Economical and Social Council work? This organ is work with the help of their different agency like UNESCO, UNICEF, WHO, WTO, UNDP. So different type of agencies are using here to do the welfare of social and economical of all over the world. Means this organ, Economical and Social Council, work with the help of different agencies. Okay class, the next organ is International Court of Justice. You know, this organ Class, this organ, International Court of Justice. This organ hear the dispute of between the different countries and try to settle the issues between the different countries. And you know, their headquarters is at The Hague in the Netherlands. This International Court of Justice is the last court at the international level. And all the member of UNO accept the decision of International Court of Justice. It work as a work on the matter of disputes between the different countries. It work on the dispute on the on different dispute among the different countries. Okay, you know class. 15 judges are elected for 9 years. 15 judges are elected for 9 years in this International Court of Justice, and you know, they have an absolute majority in the General Assembly and Security Council, okay, by the absolute majority of Security Council and General Assembly, these 15 judges are elected here in the International Court of Justice for 9 years. Class, your next organ is secretariat. You know, secretariat is working like a, this is a working body. All the executive workers are here. This is the executive parts of our, well, no, secretariat. Okay, you know who is the present general secretary of UNO is Antonio Guterres. Okay, and he, this is the office here. All the executive work is done here. Okay, all the executive works are doing here. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट आपका जो है ऑर्गन इज ट्रस्टीशिप काउंसिल. नेक्स्ट ऑर्गन इज ट्रस्टीशिप काउंसिल. एंड यू नो क्लास, दिस ऑर्गन वॉज सस्पेंडेड ऑन 1 नवंबर 1994. ओके, विद विद द यू नो पलाउ वॉज द लास्ट कंट्री विच गॉट द इंडिपेंडेंट in 1994. Then after, on this, on 1 November 1994, this organ trusteeship council was suspended, and Palau was the last territory who got the independence. Okay, so now there is no use of trusteeship council, so this was banned in the current time. Okay class, these are the 6 organs of international organization. Again I revise, summarize. The first organ is General Assembly. The second organ is the Security Council. Third organ, Economical and Social Council. And fourth is International Court of Justice. Fifth is Secretariat. And the fifth, next 6 is Trusteeship Council. And you know, this Trusteeship Council was disbanded. And in current time, you know, the work of Security Council was very important, okay? Because, you know, class, India was headed the Security Council from 1 January 2021, and India was heading the leading the Security Council till 31st August 1922. So this Security Council was headed by India, and you know, India is the member of Security Council. India is non-permanent member, and India was elected for 2 years. So nowadays India is elected a member of Security Council for 2 years, and from in this 2 years India was headed this organization's Security Council. And you know, India is working and trying to resolve the international issues very fairly. Class, you know, during the Cold War era, this UNO was not working properly, because US and USSR were both are equally powerful, and they were avoiding the UNO, and basically USSR was using their veto power, and sometime USA. So the UNO was not successful work in the affairs of world. Okay, so after the end of Cold War, the situation was changed. Now USSR was banned and disintegrated, and it is proved that there is America is the strongest power, and Soviet Communist China was emerging as a new powerful country, and the economy of Asia was improving very fast rate, and you know, world are changing the new problem like genocides and terrorism. So the situation are different. Worlds are facing the problem of epidemics in the world. In present times, you are looking, the whole world is facing the COVID-19. So similarly, this is a challenge. After the end of Cold War and situation was changed, so in this situation, can UNO work properly, or they have same problem like during the Cold War? Now after the end of Cold War, do UNO have a chance to work again, because UNO become more representative after getting many independence? Many countries were joined the UNO, and now UNO become more representative body in all over the world. So the situation was changed after the Cold War, so we should hope ki UNO was work at effectively in the contemporary world. Plus, I want to give some information about the agency of Economical and Social Council. You know, UNO have a 6 organ. Among these 6 organ, Economical and Social Council is one. And Economical and Social Council work with the help of different agencies like UNESCO. Students, full form of UNESCO is United Nations Educational Scientific Cultural Organization, and it was set up on 4 November 1946 at the Paris in France, and the objectives of this organization to promote education, science, culture, communication, class. From the few years, the UNESCO was focused only in the field of education and to provide training programs and technical education. Nowadays, UNESCO was concentrate their work on the literacy, provide the technological information, train the peoples, and they work on for the independence of media in all over the world. Last, next agency is International Labour Organization, and this was founded on October 1919, and their headquarters is at the Geneva in the Switzerland. You know, this agency was very old agency, and they focus for the welfare of workers. They work for the welfare of workers, provide safe working condition, provide social justice, provide equal working condition between man and woman, and provide the safety and self-respect measure for the workers. They also arrange the safe working condition for the workers and self-respect measures in the institution for the workers.